Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Roger with Electronics and Gadgets. If this is your first time here, thanks for stopping by. Hit the like and subscribe, please. If you've been here before, thank you. So my next video is going to be on iOS 15's new iCloud privacy relay, and is it better than a VPN? When Apple announced iCloud at the WWDC 2021 Developer Conference, one key feature that caught the attention of a lot of internet users was iCloud Privacy Relay. But what exactly is iCloud Privacy Relay? It's Apple's new way of calling a VPN in iOS 15. That's what I'd like to discuss in my next video of Apple's iCloud Privacy Relay and learn if it's better than a VPN or not. iCloud Private Relay is Apple's latest privacy-friendly addition to enhance the privacy of users while browsing the web on Safari. It is part of the new iCloud Plus subscription that's available for paid iCloud customers. Behind the scenes, Private Relay uses a dual-hop architecture. While you browse the internet, all the web traffic that leaves your device is encrypted and sent through two internet relays. So get a little technical here and bear with me. While the first relay assigns an anonymous IP address, the second relay decrypts the web address and takes users to that destination. This way, no single entity can identify the user and the sites they visit. For the second relay, Apple has partnered with third-party providers. From a technical standpoint, you should know that private relay involves an ingress proxy and an egress proxy. Ingress proxy accepts connections from the internet and makes sure other servers don't access your IP address and encrypts your internet traffic. On the other hand, egress proxy relays back to the internet while also preventing ingress proxy from seeing the websites you visit. While Apple doesn't name its content partners yet, user reports suggest that the company has partnered with Cloudflare and Fastly for egress proxy or exit mode. Think of it as a VPN, but Apple's implementation of Private Relay isn't exactly the same as what you would find on a VPN. So I'm next going to talk about what is the difference between an Apple Private Relay versus a true VPN. For starters, Private Relay maps users to a different location in their region. This is unlike VPN, where users can choose the destination. Put that into perspective, you may not necessarily be able to access a website that's banned in your country with Private Relay. That's clearly not the case with a VPN, where you can choose any supported location in the world to access geo-restricted content. So, if you were planning to use Private Relay, which is best to watch, say, Netflix shows that are not available in your country, you're out of luck. So, is Private Relay, Apple's version, better than a traditional VPN service? Will Private Relays replace a paid VPN? My guess is no, because you don't get the ability to bypass the location restrictions and browse with your desired location. Is it better than a free VPN in most cases? Yes. If all you want to do is browse the internet without being tracked, and you happen to be a paid iCloud user who also uses Safari browser, which is just limited to the abilities of using Safari browser, then you should switch to Private Relay. So, how do you enable iCloud Privacy Relay? First off, of course, you have to have the new iOS 15 developer's copy. Then, open Settings app in your iPhone, tap on the Apple ID preview card, present at the top, and choose iCloud. Under iCloud settings, tap on Private Relay and enable the private relay toggle from the next page. You can now start using iCloud Private Relay with Safari browser. You could also install extensions in Safari on iOS 15 to elevate the experience. So that's pretty much everything you should know before using the iCloud Privacy Relay. As mentioned earlier, iCloud Privacy Relay is not a VPN killer, and paid VPN services are still superior in terms of features and flexibility. So that was my video on why the iCloud Privacy Relay is not better and what it is and about it. I hope you found my videos to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below, and until next time, I'm out.